Guys, Greg C96 here, coming at you with the MHC April 2017 player update for episode 5/day 4, because it starts on day 0. So, I got my notes here, I'm ready to go. It is Wednesday now. It's supposed to be uploaded on Monday, but it is Wednesday, currently 5:49 p.m. So far, I gave them the benefit of the doubt. I waited a couple days, but Taylor the Pig, New Azusa, and Load Central did not post their next videos yet, so they are going to be omitted from this update. Now, with the people who actually posted, let's get going. Tim wasted part of his episode Googling how to make mossy cobblestone, so good on you there, Tim. Smooth. But after his Googling, he actually made a pretty nice looking front to his base, so it was worth the time. He mined for a good chunk of the night, I think all of the night, actually. I have in my notes here, I'm supposed to sing a joke, so I'm gonna sing the joke. Apparently in my head, it popped up with, "Mined by night, away from here," and, I'm gonna put it right here, what song that is, for all the young people in this challenge, and I have no idea what song that is. He finally got diamonds, and they also happen to be the ones that I found in my episode 5. So yeah, that's cool, and spoiler what I did. Next up, we got John Fall. He started the episode jumping down his mountain, not using his stairs he just spent an episode on. So, good on you, John. He finished off the roof deck. He embiggened his farm, and he built a... I would best describe it as a natural-looking melon patch. I think it's actually going to look pretty cool once melons start growing. And as a little Easter egg, at 7:30 in his video, he looked like he was debating hard whether or not to jump off the tallest tree in the area. So, yeah. Next up, we got the one, the only original Junior. He was talking about in his episode how that was the last thing he was recording on that day. He had recorded 10 videos in a row. Goddamn, man, that's a lot. He did some fishing, he spent quite a chunk of the episode mining, he got himself to the Nether with a pretty good portal location, but it doesn't seem like he's planning on going back, so there's that. Next up, we got Javadad. He started off the episode with a short little conversation with his parrot friend. From my perspective, it seemed like a pretty one-sided conversation, so I had to know, is your parrot named Wilson? Let me know, Javadad. Let me know, JD. Is your parrot Wilson? He also made a treetop farm, and he's doing some really cool expansion. His base is actually looking really nice. Go check it out if you haven't watched his videos yet. His base is looking really good. Next up, Linda over at Grandma's Gone Gaming. She did a lot more adventuring. I don't think she's stopped yet. She just keeps going. It's like the Energizer Bunny on those videos. She's gotta be stupid far away from spawn by this point. She made an anvil and did some more mining. So, yep. Next up, we got Dark Age Man. He went on a hunt for gold. He was looking for gold for... I don't remember specifically what it was for. At the very end of the episode, he had a close call with a creeper, but then he got himself stuck in a corner against a skeleton. And unfortunately, that ended pretty badly for him. So, he is out of the challenge this month. Next up, we got our old buddy DadCraft73. Someone's calling me. Hold up. Hello? Little tip for you there, guys. When you get those spam calls... Okay, so, sidetracked entirely. When you get those spam calls like that, the pre-record... Especially, it really only works for the pre-recorded ones. If it's a real person trying to scam you, it won't necessarily work, unless they just get annoyed and pissed off. But those spam calls, they're looking for some sort of a human response. So they just have a database of numbers that they go through. So they don't know if they're calling actual phone numbers or fax lines. So what you can do is, you can, either I used to just leave a recording of a dial-up tone on my phone. So whenever I got a call like that, I would run the dial-up tone. It works really good on a landline. Well, the other thing you can do is you can kind of pseudo-simulate the dial-up tone, or the dial tone, basically. In the case of what I did, it was the dial tone, by just randomly pressing numbers, and as long as you don't start off with an 8 or a 5, you should be good. So that's how you deal with those scam callers. Anyways, now back to our regularly scheduled programming. that's right, we left off with our old buddy Dadcraft. Sheared some trees at the top of the episode, finished the little leaf roof on his hut there that he was building. He had a zombie attempt Grand Theft Aqua on him. That was funny. All of a sudden he looked down and a zombie was stealing his boat. And he made some smoke for his chimney out of... I don't even remember what block it was now. I'll put a little thing on it. I just got a text message, too. I should have just put my phone on Do Not Disturb when I had it in my hand. That would have made sense if I was good at what I do. But you know. You don't watch me because I'm good at what I do. But yeah, I'll put it on screen what block he used because I don't remember off the top of my head. Next on this list, we got myself. I did some mining. I realized that I probably was not going to be able to catch leather to make the enchanting table, so I kind of gave up on that. I found a bunch of diamonds in episode 5, and I also managed to be a complete idiot, which I explained in a little disclaimer at the top of the episode, and I'm going to end up making a separate video about it. My episode 5 looked like trash. Not really worth watching. Next up, we got Nobody's LP, All the Way J, and Katie Reed. Watched a cat commit murder against a innocent chicken who did nothing wrong. And they fought pretty hard to bring some cows back to the base. Which I'm not entirely sure why, since they can't kill passive mobs. So maybe they'll chime in, or it'll become clear in the next couple of episodes. We got Outfoxed. He started work on a treehouse, and he finished off the basic layout of the treehouse. It's not looking too bad. Next up, Granny's Got Game. She chopped up some trees, started on a... I don't even know what that message says. None of that is spelled correctly. Alright, let me use some brain power here and try to remember what the hell that was. She built a platform and she's starting to try to put a jungle giant tree on that platform and kind of make a middle of a lake treehouse, which is pretty cool. She also did... I remember now. She had done some really, really cool design stuff with... You can put trap doors on top of fences and then flip them up and they look really cool. That was really good. And I'm guessing she also lost track of time because she did not have a proper outro on said video. Next up, we got Honeysuckle, who, if I recall correctly, based on my notes here, basically mined the entire episode and even commented about how it wasn't too exciting. And last up, we got Kashka and Valen over at Mischief of Mice. They finished their dock and got working on a pretty big treehouse. They were artificially building the tree and doing, like, spiral staircase up the center of the tree trunk. So that's looking like it should be pretty cool. And that's all I got for notes. So, yeah, that's what everyone's doing. If you've watched this video, you also got that useful tip about dealing with automated scam calls. And that does it for this update. So, thanks for watching. We'll see you guys in the next one. Peace! Hey, thanks for making it all the way through this video. If you're still in the mood to watch some more, why don't you check out one of these previous videos here? Or, if you want to watch more later, but not right now, that's cool too. If you click on one of my lovely pieces of wall art here, you can either subscribe to myself, or to the Big Box of Gamers channel. Just make sure after you subscribe, you click that little bell notification icon there to get notified whenever we post a new video. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you guys in the next one.